Good morning, friends. Welcome to Bahu Automation Lab once again. In this series of Java programming, in lecture 6, we will see Java variables. This is the very important concept while working with Java programming. Okay, in the last lecture, we have seen how to create a Java project, how to create packages inside the Java project, and how to create a classes inside the packages. Okay, if you're not watched the lecture for 1 to 5, please watch lecture 1 to 5 first and then come to the lecture 6. It will help for you. So let's start with the Java variables. Okay, in Java we have three types of variables: local variables, global variables, and static variables. For the global variables, we can named as instance variable also. Okay, we'll see the practically what is local variables, what is global variables, and what is static variables. For the local variables, in theoretical part, the definition of local variables is a local variable is in a Java variable that is declared within a body or method. In single body or method, if you, any variables is declared, it's kind of called as a local variables in Java. Okay, you can use the variable only within a method. In one single method, you can use the local variable only. You can't use the local variable outside the method. If let's take out the example of this class, if we have a one public class like dog here, one method inside that class, like age of that class, like a put age, okay, and we just run this class through this main method as a creating object of that class. What is this object creation of the class, we will see in the next lectures, incoming lectures, like object creation part. Just understand the variables here. If you run this program, we will see the output as the age of this dog. Okay, but here in this method, we have declared the variable name as age is equal to 0. This is the local variable because this variable is declared in this body only. Okay. We'll see this practically, how to see what is local and global variable, okay, in Eclipse also. Just understand the concept here. The local variable is in the Java is declared within the body. You can't use that variable outside the method body. What is global variable? A global variable is one declared at the start of the code, and it's accessible for the all parts of the program, okay? Whenever we declare any global variable, it's outside the methods, okay, the start of the program or start of the class, and it will are applicable for all the methods which we have written in the one single class automatically because it's a global variable. Variable declared inside the class but outside the methods. Whatever methods we have, if there are 5 methods in your one single class, if you declare any global variable in the class level, okay, you can easily access that variable all the class which is you declare in that class, all the methods which is declared in that class. If 5 methods, you can access global variable in all the 5 methods automatically. Okay, so just understand the concept. A global variable is declared at the start of the code, okay, it is accessible all the parts of the program, and variable is declared inside the class but outside the method. Like here is the one method like public integer add, and we have two global variables like int x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 5. Okay, it's outside the method but inside the class. Okay, we'll see this concept also practically in Eclipse. Just understand the concept here. Now see the static variable. So static variable is variable declared as a static keyword. Okay, it's called as a static variable, nothing extra. Static means nothing change, or we can't change anything there. Okay, never change. The variables cannot be a local variable. Static variable cannot be a local variable. It's always global variable. Okay, whenever we declare any static variable, it's a global variable only. The static variable can be used for refer to the common property of all the object, which is not unique or each object. For example, the company name, employees, college name, students, etc. The static variable gets memory only once in the class area at the time of class loading. as it is a static variable declared as a class level, okay, it will get variable gets the memory only once when class is load, okay, and the things that is will never change, like a company name, employee name, college name, we can declare as a static in the your program. Like here, static string college name is a static variable. Int college PG is equal to 50,000. It's a global variable, and public void student. It's the method level variable, like a string student name. So it's a local variable. So all these three variables are declared here. Like this is the static variable, this is the global variable, and this is a local variable inside the void. Okay, let's see these concepts practically once, guys. First of all, we will see local and global variables. Okay, so I'll just open my Eclipse here, and I'll create one more package in this project only. So package, as we are seeing variables, right? Variables in Java. So I'll create one package name as a com. Variables in Java. So I'll just create a package name as a variables, and I'll create a one class inside this package. Okay, so class name is boy. One class as a name as a boy. Okay, so I'll create a one method inside this package, like public void. How to create a method and everything we will see easily in the next chapters, but just understand the variable declarations here. So public void boy age, the one method. Okay, inside that method I'll create a one local variable. Whenever you create any variable inside the method, it's called as a local variable. So int age is equal to 25. Okay, so this variable is declared inside this method, like boy age, like, okay. So this what we seen in the theoretical concept, local variable in Java variable that declared within a body. So this variable is declared within a body. So and you can use this variable only within a body. So I can use this variable in this body only, right? So this method is called as a local method, local variable. Okay. This is called as a local variable. Okay, now we will create a one global variable also. Okay. Like I'll create a one global variable here, like global or instance variable, like int. I'll take one number. Variable name as a number is equal to like 5. We can see the difference here. Like whenever we create a variable, we can see the difference of two variables declaration easily here. Like whenever you declare any instance or global variable, you can see the different color. Like, okay, instance or global variable showing in Eclipse like in the blue color, okay, and local variable showing in the difference color, right? So you can easily differentiate two variables, like global variable and local variable. So this variable is called as global or instance variable. Okay, this variable is called as instance or global or instance variable. So whenever you declare a variable inside the class but outside the method, it's called as a global or instance variable and local variable. So these are the two examples of local and global variables. Okay, so global variable is accessible all the methods inside the class. Okay, whenever you declare any global variable, it will be applicable to all the methods. So I'll create one more method here, like public void like addition of two numbers. Okay. Public void addition to number. Let me create a one local variable here again. Int second number is equal to, let's say, 9. And I'll create one more variable here, like an int addition of numbers is equal to, I want to addition of this number and this number. So this global number variable is declared globally inside the class, but outside the method. Okay. I just want to addition of this global variable and this local variable. Okay, so I can access easily this local variable here and global variable also. So how to access that? For local variable, we will pass here a second number, and for global here, we can directly get global number variable from global variable. Okay. If I print here system.out.println addition of two number, addition of two numbers, we can see the output as a addition of this second number and this global variable number automatically in this addition of two number variable. So this number, as a we declare number as a global variable, and this is accessible in this addition method, also in this boy age method also. So how to check that? So here we can check age plus, we can access the number here, age plus number. Int age and number is equal to system.out.println. Each number. So what we have seen here, like boy age is the local variable of age. Age is 25. I have one declared the global variable here, like number, and it is accessible for here in this method also and in this method also. So this is the example of global and local variable. If I run this program through creating main method, like I'll just create a main method here, public static void main, and access this, create this object of this boy class, boy b is equal to new boy. So how to create this object, what is mean by this object, we will see one by one in the next chapter and next class. You just understand here, we need to create a object of this this class to run this both methods in single shot. Okay, so we by create object as a b and just put a dot here, so I can easily access this both methods, like boy age and b dot additions. We need to write a main method to run this program, right? So if I run this program, run as a Java application, you can see the output as a 30. So how is 30 coming? Because my number is declared as a 5 and age is declared as a 25. Here is the addition of this two, number and age. So addition is 30. And when we go to the addition method, here second number is declared as a 9. Okay, and the global number is declared as a 5. Okay, so second number is a local variable declared as a 9 and a global variable is declared as a 5. So addition of 9 and 5 is equal to 14. And here local variable declared as a 25 and added global variable declared as a 5. So output is a 30. So these are the local variables which is declared inside the method, and these are the global variable which is declared as a outside the methods but inside the class. Okay. I hope so you understand clearly what is local and global variable here, global or instance variable here. Okay, if you not if you have any query regarding this, you can just come it out me. I'll answer it. What is your doubt? We will clear easily. If you have any doubt related to the this concept like global and local variable. Now we will see as per the your slide. We have seen global and local variable. Now we will see static variable. So static variable as a declare as a we need to declare the variable as a static. When we declare the variable as a static, whenever the things like never change, like company name, employee name, college name, student's name, these types of things, if you have seen in your project, you can easily declare that variables as a static variables. Okay, and the static variable can be refer a common property of object which is not unique for each object. For example, company name, employee name, like that. Okay, variable declared as a static is called as a static variable. For example, I'll create one more class here, like okay, class name is college. Here declare as a we'll declare one global variable first here, int college fees is equal to like 50,000 is the college fees. Okay, this is called as a global variable as we have seen previously. Okay, now we will create one method here, public void student. Required student. Okay, here we write one local method because it's inside the body, like okay, string student name is the local variable. Now we will declare one static variable. Like how to declare a static variable, just write public static or static string college name, right? College name will be never changed, so we will declare as a variable as a static variable. So in this example, the college fee is the global variable which is accessible all the methods whichever you write in this project. Okay, the static string college name is the static variable because it will never change as a college name. Okay, so we will declare as a static. And this is the local variable which is declared inside the body. So this type of variable we can call as a static variable in Java. Okay, hope so guys you are understand all the concept practically and theoretically, conceptually also. You have doubt related to this, you can just connect with me. I'll explain everything practically again. So this is the method, this is the concept of static variable, global variable and local variable in Java. Okay, just practice by yourself and just create these programs with another example. You can understand very clearly about local, global and static variables in Java. Okay, we'll meet in next lecture, in lecture 7 we will see the next topic. Okay, till time have a great day, bye bye.